spreading the word to the people who needed to hear. Oh, how readily did he accept Muhammad's message from God? Abu Bakr Siddiq, the Prophet's faithful friend, trusted and protected him. His love had no end. Abu Bakr Siddiq, Allah be pleased with him, companion in Jannah, oh blessed by Allah. Abu
Bakr. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدا عبد الله ورسوله. Brothers and sisters in Islam, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. And welcome again to Righteous Companions. Brothers and sisters in Islam, the last episode, my message was to my Muslim sisters not to marry a kafir, but to marry a Muslim. And my message today also to my Muslim sisters, daughters, is to marry a righteous Muslim. Yes, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in this regard, إِذَا جَاءَكُمْ مَنْ تَرْضَوْنَ خُلُقَهُ وَدِينَهُ فَزَوِّجُوهُ. If someone who comes to you who has good character and good deen, give him your daughters in marriage. Why? My dear sisters, my dear daughters, because when you choose a man to marry, you're not only choosing a husband for yourself, rather, you're choosing a father for your children. Brothers and sisters in Islam, my story today is about a companion, but I'm not after the companion. Even so, he is worthy because he is the main character in the story. But I'm after a woman, a Muslim woman, who made the right call. And she chosen what Allah and His Messenger chosen for her, that you marry a righteous man. She did not want to disobey Allah and His Messenger. And she made that call. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rewarded her. What is the story of this woman? And what this has to do with the companion? You may have not heard about this companion either, but I'm sure a lot of you do. A lot of you did. The companion's name is Jolaybeeb. Jolaybeeb, brothers and sisters in Islam, to say the least, is not the man that any woman wishes to be married to. He's not rich, he's not wealthy, he is not handsome at all. Actually, in some wording, his appearance was not accepted in a way. I hate to say this about a companion of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He is not a good-looking person. But إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَنْظُرُ إِلَى صُوَرِكُمْ وَلَا إِلَى أَجْسَامِكُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not look into your faces or your bodies. وَلَكِنْ يَنْظُرُ إِلَى قُلُوبِكُمْ. But He looks into your hearts. A person may have the best face, but his heart is a sick one. Jolaybeeb had a very good heart. One day he was sitting with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he noticed, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam noticed that Jolaybeeb is interested in women. And he asked him, Why don't you marry, O Jolaybeeb? لماذا لا تتزوج يا جوليبيب؟ And Jolaybeeb was a realistic man. He said, O Messenger of Allah, who will marry me? Who will give me his daughter or sister in marriage? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, I will. أنا أزوجك. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam made a promise to Jolaybeeb to find him a wife. It was the habit in Medina that when a father would have a daughter who is at the age of marriage, he would come to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in order to recommend for her a husband. So one day, this father approached the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and he said, O Messenger of Allah, my daughter would like to get married. Can you recommend a husband? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told the father, Ankihha Jolaybeeb. Ankihha Jolaybeeba. Let her marry Jolaybeeb. The father immediately, Jolaybeeb. And then he did not know what to do. And he said, O Messenger of Allah, I have to talk to her mother first. He went home and he spoke with his wife. When the daughter is listening to the conversation of her father and mother from behind a curtain, as they were talking about the marriage proposal of Jolaybeeb, the father told his wife that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam brought a husband to our daughter. The mother immediately showing happiness and joy. Yes, for sure. Then the father tells the mother, you want to know who the husband is? Who is that person? She said, yes. He said, Jolaybeeb. Immediately the woman, right away, the mother, whoa, no, no, Jolaybeeb, no, no, no. A caring mother. She wants her daughter to marry someone else. Look, the woman, the daughter, comes from behind the curtain. And she says to her father and mother, are you refusing someone who was recommended by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Are you? I will not do it. I want to marry this man. It's my life. It's my free will. I will not refuse someone whom Allah and His Messenger recommended for me. My dear sisters, my dear daughters, when a righteous man comes to you asking your guardians in marriage, and if they are righteous but yet they do not have other qualities, riches, lineage, position, and you're refusing them, you are refusing what Allah and His Messenger has chosen for you. وما كان لمؤمن ولا مؤمنة إذا قضى الله ورسوله أمرا أن يكون لهم الخيرة من أمرهم. It is not fitting for a believing man or a believing woman when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger decide something that they have a choice. يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تقدموا بين يدي الله ورسوله. O ye who believe, do not take any precedence, your opinion, your whim, your desire, ahead of Allah and His Messenger. This daughter, brothers and sisters in Islam, decided to stick and to submit to Allah and His Messenger. And she married Jolaybeeb. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was the one who put them in marriage together. And he made dua for them. Allahumma subba alayhima al-khayra sabba wa la taj'al 'aysahuma kadda. O Allah, pour goodness on them and do not make their livelihood difficult. Brothers and sisters in Islam, a while, just days after that marriage, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had to go to fight in a battle. And Jolaybeeb did not want to miss. Jolaybeeb radiyallahu anhu went to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam fighting. Brothers and sisters in Islam, in the battle, when the battle erupted, Jolaybeeb fought so hard, they found him, brothers and sisters in Islam, killed next to 7 disbelievers. He killed 7 and they killed him. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, after the battle ended, he addressed his companion saying, "Don't you miss anybody? I miss somebody. I don't see Jolaybeeb. Where is Jolaybeeb?" They looked for him and they found him next to 7 disbelievers. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam carries him in his hand and he says, "He killed 7 and then they killed him. هذا مني وأنا منه. هذا مني وأنا منه. هذا مني وأنا منه. He's from me and I'm from him. He's from me and I'm from him. He's from me and I'm from him." The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam with his own hands was the one who placed him in his graveyard, brothers and sisters in Islam. This daughter became a widow. This wife of Jolaybeeb became a widow. Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu anhu, the narrator of this hadith, he said that people were lining up trying to get married to her because of one quality that she had. She obeyed Allah and His Messenger. Brothers and sisters in Islam, let's take a short break and come back and reflect a little bit more about this beautiful story. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
I rarely did accept Muhammad's message from God.
Huda TV strives to bring you, our viewers, the best in Islamic programming. Please send your comments and suggestions to feedback at huda.tv.
Muhammad's message from God.
Brothers and sisters in Islam, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Before the break, I shared the story with you and I decided to use the rest of the time to reflect upon that story. Not a handsome, not a rich, not a prestigious husband, but righteous, came to a woman chosen by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and she refused to let him go. Rather, she decided to marry him, and the reward was obvious. My dear daughters and sisters, we all talk about love. And we were brought up in an environment, soap operas, movies, they always talk to you about a love story between a man and a woman. And normally the story would end like they married one another and then they lived happily ever after. My sisters, my daughters, that is not the case. They never show you What happens after marriage? Marriage is a test. Marriage is an institution. Marriage is a project. You want a good partner. You want a quality partner. And that quality partner is a righteous man. There is no harm in marrying a rich, handsome, prestigious, good family man. But these are not the criteria. My sisters in Islam, they always share with us beautiful love stories between Romeo and Juliet, Cleopatra and Antonio, and others. So many names in different cultures. But you want to know the best love story I ever read, I ever learned, the best love story in the whole world was between a man and a woman. The woman was 15 years older than him. I'm talking about Khadija and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Aisha radiallahu anha, brothers and sisters in Islam, she made that statement and she said, I have never been jealous from the living wives of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam more than I'm jealous of Khadija. Khadija is dead. Khadija is not alive. And when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would mention her, I can tell how much excited he is about her. Khadija used to have a sister, her name is Hala. And when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would hear the voice of Hala outside, he would say, Allahumma Hala, this is Hala, get me Hala. And when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would slaughter a sheep, he would make sure that he tells his wives, make sure that you give some of that sheep to the friends of Khadija. Aisha radiallahu anha would say, why are you doing this to Khadija? Hamra ash-shidqain. She had no teeth. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala replaced her with bitter women, bitter wives like myself. Here is the statement that I'm looking for, brothers and sisters in Islam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells Aisha radiallahu anha, Ya Aisha, laqad ruziqtu hubbaha. Her love was placed in my heart. You see, these hearts are not in our hands. Obey Allah and Allah will make you love your husband. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is showing the ummah that the love comes from Allah. If you obey Allah, Allah will make you love your husband and will make your husband loves you. I'll share with you a real life story that happened at our time. A man who went to the work in the Gulf countries, in Emirates, for years, 20 years. Very poor to begin with. He became wealthy. His father was a very righteous man. He used to be the imam. This is a real life story. It's not a sci-fi. So the man, after accumulating all his wealth, he sent to his father, my father, I want to get married. A lot of the years passed by without getting married. Now it's the time. And I want you to choose a wife for me. And I want you to go ahead and put the marriage contract together. And I want to go into the actual marriage. The wedding day, I want it to be the day that I arrive. And I don't want to see her. This is how much trust this man, this young man, had in his father. Of course, a righteous man knows that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said a woman is asked in marriage for four reasons: wealth, beauty, lineage, and the deen. You better go for the deen. He chosen a quality religious woman, wife for his son, but yet her physical appearance was not the best. The son arrives to Egypt at the airport. He's picked up and he is taken to his wife, who was wearing a veil, and then basically he got into the room with her alone. As soon as she unveiled herself, he became shocked. He became shocked. This is the wife that my father chose for me. She's not beautiful. She's not beautiful. He became so depressed. Here I am coming after all these years, so excited, so excited. He became so depressed. So he slept. Towards the last third of the night, the wife, who understood the reaction of the husband, she tried to wake him up. He refused. She tried again. He refused. And then she sprinkled water on him to wake him up. So he waked up and she spoke to him and she said, I know how much disappointed you are. And I understand I'm not beautiful. But you know what? I wished to get married for one reason. I wanted to implement the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he said, Rahim Allahum rajulan, may Allah have mercy on a man who wakes up to pray at night, and then he would wake up his wife. And if she does not wake up, nadaha alayha al-ma, he would sprinkle water on her to wake up. And this is the segment that she wanted to implement. ورحم الله امرأة, a wife. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mercy on a woman, grant his mercy to a wife who wakes up to pray tahajjud at night. And she wakes her husband up to pray with her. And if he does not wake up, she sprinkles water in him. Wallahi, I'm so grateful to you that you granted me that wish. I wanted to implement that hadith so much, and I was a little bit hopeless that I will get married because I know I'm not beautiful. Can you please now fulfill the rest of this hadith with me? Can you wake up and just lead me in salah, pray tahajjud with me? He waked up and he led her in salah. Brothers and sisters in Islam, this man swears by Allah that as soon as he ended his tahajjud, leading her in salah, I looked at her as if I'm looking at the most beautiful woman in this world. That's the way it goes, akhi. Don't be deceived by all these soap operas and movies. The love gets to the heart because of Allah. Allah can make you love your husband, but you and your husband obey Allah. Lead your wives in salah. Have your husbands lead you in salah at night. This family, brothers and sisters in Islam, they have grandchildren who memorize the Quran, and they are students of knowledge, and some of them are about to be scholars of this ummah. Brothers and sisters in Islam, don't compromise nor test the commands of Allah. If you want to live happily, like they say in the movie Ever After, marriage is a tough institution. Enough that shaitan every day places the crown on the head of a shaitan who separates a husband and wife. You need a good partner for the mission, and the quality that you must seek is the quality that this wife seeked in Jolaybeeb, this daughter seeked in Jolaybeeb, righteousness and piety. And if you do, you will get the best of this dunya. And bi-idhnillahi ta'ala, you will be with your reformed husband and reformed wife, azwaj al-mutahara, purified spouses in Jannah. Don't miss the next episode of Righteous Companions. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Companions spread in the world to the people who needed to hear. Oh, how readily did he accept Muhammad's message from God? Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, the Prophet's faithful friend, trusted and protected him. His love had no end. Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, Allah be pleased with him, companion in Jannah, oh blessed by Allah. Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, the Prophet's faithful friend.